So hello friends, welcome you once again our Litmus YouTube platform. Today in this video, we will see the current affairs of July 1 to July 3. Guys, most of you are preparing for SBI JEE, that is Junior Associate, and the prelims examination of SBI JEE is on July 13th. So guys, preparing for this examination, need to buckle up their preparation, attempt multiple mocks, identify your strong area and as well as weak area, and try to maximize your strength in strong area, and also at the same time, try to rectify and reduce your weakness. Okay, so moving forward, yesterday I asked three questions. So Ashutosh Gupta has given the correct answer. So first question was, what is P in the full form of missile Agni P? So the right answer is prime. Then the second question was, who is the chairman of Niti Aayog? So the Niti Aayog chairman is PM of India. So right now it is Narendra Modi, and the headquarter of Badminton World Federation is at Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Okay. So moving forward to the first news of today. So RBI has released its financial stability report. Guys, we will provide you the detail of financial stability report in our RBI Grade B course. But for the sake of banking examination, this much is very important and this much is very suffice. Okay. So the bank NPS could rise to 9.8% by March 2022. So RBI has provided this GNPA data in three scenario, means four scenario. First one is actual case, and other three stress scenario is, first one is baseline scenario, then it is medium stress scenario and severe stress scenario. So you need to remember all these three data, but most important one is baseline scenario because it is the standard way of projection. Okay, so as per baseline scenario, the GNPA will rise to 9.8% in by March 2022. All right, moving forward to the another news. So IOB, that is Indian Overseas Bank, is now second most valued public lender. So which bank, means which public lender is at top position? So it is State Bank of India, and the MCAP of State Bank of India is 3.78 trillion US, means trillion rupees. Okay, that is 378,000 crore. Okay, so IOB is at second position, and the MCAP of IOB is now over 50,000 crore. And what is the main reason? So as you know that there is the news of privatization, so its share has appreciated nearly 80% on the Bombay Stock Exchange in the past 1 month. We will see the graph of its share also. So at the third position it is now PNB, Punjab National Bank, and at the fourth spot it is BOB. Must remember that we are talking about public lender. If you also consider private lender, so HDFC is at top position with 8.18 trillion, that is 818,000 crore rupees. Okay, so you can see here that the privatization plan was announced in the Union Budget as part of the government's broader disinvestment goals for FY22. It includes privatization of several other non-financial state-owned entities and listing of the wholly owned Life Insurance Corporation of India also. Okay, moving forward. So you can see here, this is the share chart of IOB, Indian Overseas Bank. So initially its share was very low, then near global financial crisis it rose up to 200, and then it started declining, and currently in the last month there is a rise of 80%. So 1 or 2 months before its share was 10 rupees, means 10 rupees per share, but now it is nearly 20 to, you can see here that it is right there, that is 27.4 INR. okay, so from 17 in 1 month there is a rise of 81%, and it is now at 27.4 rupees. So this is the reason why IOB is now at second position. Moving forward, RBI changes methodology to ensure bond auction success. So to ensure bond auction success, RBI has tweaked something, like they have decided that you can see here that RBI changed its bond auction methodology and said, till further notice, bonds maturing between 2 to 14 years. Okay, that means 2 to 14 years. Which type of bonds are there? So they are 2-year bond, 3-year bond, 5-year bond, 10-year bond, and 14-year bond. So five kind of bonds, एंड देर आर समथिंग लाइक फ्लोटिंग रेट बॉन्ड्स ऑल्सो. सो दिस विल बी ऑक्शन अंडर यूनिफॉर्म प्राइस मेथड. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड नॉट मल्टीपल प्राइस मेथड. हाउएवर दे आर टू अदर टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड, दैट इज 30-year बॉन्ड एंड 40-year बॉन्ड. सो दिस टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड विल कंटिन्यू टू बी ऑक्शन एट मल्टीपल प्राइस मेथड. ऑलराइट, सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज, आरबीआई ट्विक्स नॉर्म्स फॉर इंटरेस्ट ऑन अनक्लेम्ड डिपॉजिट्स. सो आरबीआई हैज ट्विक्स द नॉर्म फॉर ऑन द अमाउंट लेफ्ट अनक्लेम्ड विद द बैंक आफ्टर ए टर्म डिपॉजिट मैच्योर्स. सो दिस इज बेसिकली इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर दोज गाइज हु आर प्रिपेरिंग फॉर द आरबीआई इंटरव्यू. सो यू कैन सी हियर दैट करेंटली इफ ए टर्म डिपॉजिट मैच्योर्स then the and proceeds are unpaid, then the amount left unclaimed with the bank attracts the rate of interest as applicable to saving deposits. But now rate of interest will be applicable as per saving account or the contracted rate of interest on the mature term deposit, whichever is lower. So the new contracted rate of interest on the mature TD has been introduced. Okay, nothing important for general candidates, but this is important for those aspirants who are preparing for RBI interview. This is very important, this news, that RBI has imposed a penalty of 25 lakh on Punjab and Sindh Bank. Why? For non-compliance with certain provisions of direction on cyber security framework in banks. Now India's exports jump 85% to 95 billion in June quarter, and this is the highest jump ever. So you can see that India recorded the highest ever exports of 95 billion during April to June, that is 1 April to 30th June, up to 85% year on year and 18% higher than the first quarter of the financial year 2019-20. You just have to remember that in this quarter export was 95 billion. Okay, and let me tell you some other data. If we talk about what was the export only in June, so in June only it was 32.46 billion. So if it, in examination it is asked only about June, so you have to tick 32.4 billion, and it is asked about June quarter, so it is 95 billion US dollar. All right, moving forward. So telecom debt jumps to 3.85 trillion in financial year 21. So just remember that telecoms debt, this is and pronounced as debt, not debt. So this is rupees 3.85 trillion. Okay, so only Reliance Jio is in profit and all others are in loss. In a bid to take Bharti Airtel, means in a bid to take on Jio, Bharti Airtel, who is the owner of Airtel as well as OneWeb, launched a new all-in-one bundle plan, Airtel Black, that includes DHT, postpaid and fiber with a single bill facility. So they are trying very hard to compete with Jio. Now a very important news, that center includes retail and wholesale under MSMEs. So Union Government on Monday announced fresh guidelines to include wholesale and retail trade as MSME in a move that is expected to benefit as many as 25 million traders battered by the COVID-19 pandemic. Okay, and who is the MSME Minister of India? So the MSME Minister of India is Nitin Gadkari. Okay, so let me ask you a question, that do you know what is the name of portal which basically provides a single page registration and simplifies the process of registering any enterprise under the MSME category? So let me tell you that the name of that portal is Udyam portal. So this is very important, okay, because this portal provides a single page registration, consumes less time and simplifies the process of registering any enterprise under the MSME category. The new Chief Minister of Uttarakhand is Pushkar Singh Dhami. Earlier it was Tirath Singh Rawat, बट ही हैज़ रिसाइंड वेरी रिसेंटली एंड द गवर्नर ऑफ उत्तराखंड इज बेबी रानी मौर्या. ओके एंड दिस इज अ बुक नेम्ड एज स्पेस लाइफ मैटर. दिस टॉक अबाउट द वर्किंग ऑफ इंडियन साइंटिस्ट एंड द ऑथर ऑफ दिस बुक इज हरी पुलक्कट. एंड ऑन July 1st इट वॉज नेशनल डॉक्टर्स डे एंड ऑल्सो SBI सेलिब्रेटेड इट्स 66th बैंक डे ऑन July 1st. सो बिकॉज द एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ SBI इज अराउंड द कॉर्नर सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. एंड इफ यू टॉक अबाउट द एक्स्ट्रा न्यूज सो अनिल अग्रवाल हु इज द चेयरमैन ऑफ वेदांता ग्रुप ही pledges 5000 crore for rural India and KPMG will distribute this money. Then Digit Insurance, this is a startup which is backed by Virat Kohli. It reached to the $3.5 billion in valuation. Then the Swedish gaming giant MTG, this gaming company has buys Play Simple for $360 million. This is also very important because this is very rare when any foreign company buys any Indian company. So basically MTG is a Swedish company while Play Simple is a Bangalore based startup. All right, then Zomato has sought the nod of CCI. What is CCI? This is Competition Commission of India. This is a very strong institution which focuses on different kind of aspects. So this has provided nod to Zomato to invest in Grofers. Okay. Then Richard Branson plans to fly in space. You know that means Jeff Bezos of Amazon is also gonna fly in space. So now Richard Branson has planned to fly in space earlier than Jeffrey Bezos on July 11. There is one person, this is very important. This is Shirish Bandla. She is Indian and this person will be the second Indian to fly into space. You can see here that beside the this person is Richard Branson and he is the founder of Virgin company and this is Shirish Bandla. Okay, then UPI, which is the flagship of NPCI, that is National Payment Corporation of India, touched a record high both in terms of volume and value of transaction in June. Okay, so what is the new volume and value of transaction of UPI? So the platform has recorded 2.8 billion transactions worth rupees 5.47 trillion in June. This data is super important for the examination. Okay, and you just have to remember this two data, that 2.8 billion transaction and the value of transaction was 5.47 trillion of UPI. Okay, so that was for today. So if you like this video, kindly share this video with your friends. And for complete access, do join our GA course. Okay, so see you in another video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.